the kitchen this morning. I'm so excited. I'm with my friend Katie McDonald. She's a wonderful holistic health coach. Be Nourished. What are we going to be make everything this morning look so, first of all, so colorful, so beautiful. The smells are just so heavenly. What are we making this morning?
We're making something really simple. Everyone talks about surviving the holidays,
right.
And that's not what I'm in for.
Right.
I'm in for thriving during the holidays.
I
want to thrive. And we thrive when we're nourished.
Right.
And so we're making a really simple, easy, easy meal to make in advance.
Right.
We're doing short grain brown rice that you can shove in the rice cooker and
just
have it do
it like that
while you're wrapping packages.
Mm-hmm.
We have hemp seed to add some protein. We're going to have red onion to help us with keeping viruses at bay. Lemon, cucumber, broccoli, carrots, which are good for the eye, right?
Absolutely.
Nature resembles exactly
what it is. Yes. Well, you've always heard that, but I had never thought that when you cut it. Absolutely.
You just need to look at nature and it tells you what it does.
Wonderful. Now tell me about too what you had said too. The red onion, it was for
keeps viruses at bay.
That is amazing.
Wonderful. Antibacterial, antiviral. You want to have onions in every meal. Not breakfast, a little rough, but
you
lunch
do that year round as well.
Especially now, and especially with kids,
right.
They're coming home with everything,
absolutely.
And you've got to keep your defenses up. And food can do that for you.
Absolutely.
Add in some garlic; it plays the same role.
Oh my gosh, that's great. So these are obviously all the ingredients we're going to need for making the whole rice bowl.
Yep.
I love it. Now, obviously in front, we have the chickpeas.
Garbanzo beans. I buy them canned. I make sure it's BPA free. Yeah, that's a shortcut. I need shortcuts this time of year.
I love it.
All year long.
Absolutely.
I look for shortcuts.
Absolutely. So everything is laid out here. We're going to obviously throughout the show be putting everything together. But I love that you said that to thrive rather than just to kind of rush the holidays.
Yeah.
And I love that you can make this in advance too.
Absolutely.
For not just moms out there too, but anyone that just wants to make a little bit more relaxing.
Make
no
a pot of rice once a week and have it throughout in a lot of different ways. Make one sauce throughout the week and you can put it on a sandwich, put it on salad dressing, put it on anything, any grain, anything.
Now, do you prep everything ahead of time?
I do. Well, once you put the rice in, you're done,
yeah.
Right? You've got the rice. This sauce that I'll show you how I made, it's three ingredients, and it took me 3 minutes.
Unbelievable.
So this is the way I roll here. It's got to be easy, but it's got to nourish us
absolutely.
At all levels.
Absolutely. And I love that, to nourish your body, nice and healthy. So, no, I'm excited to put this all together. I'm going to be making this throughout the holidays to thrive, not be stressed about it. Katie, I can't wait to do this with you throughout the show, and we're going to head back out to you guys. Nourished, and we are making a delicious rice bowl this morning. We've been talking about how this is great to make during the holidays. To really, it's delicious food, it's healthy food, it's nourishing food, and we're just talking about shortcuts that we can make because a lot of us get so stressed through the holidays. And you know what? You don't need to be. So
the first thing that goes during the holidays or any time when we're busy is our self-care.
It's true.
It's the exact. We need the exact opposite. But
it's
it
so
takes
true.
A lot
so
of retraining.
True.
So if we can come up with some really quick ways to make sure that we're taken care of, we can start the new year. So many of us start the new year.
Right.
With trying to compensate for what they did the entire month of December.
You're right.
Wouldn't you rather start January feeling phenomenal, not
absolutely.
Needing to cleanse because you're already clean, you know?
So smart. So, you know, again, with the stress and oh my goodness, I have to cook this and I have to do this. And
yeah.
Maybe you have children at home. What are some of the shortcuts that you can do when you're making the rice bowl that you said, are okay to make? You
absolutely.
Don't need to be,
so,
should be worried.
A lot of people are intimidated about making brown rice and they'll do the minute rice in the microwave and
right.
everything else. And when you get a rice cooker, it's one of the pieces of gear that can make things so much easier.
Right.
You put it in and you're done.
And
you're
it.
Not going to screw it up.
Right.
The machine's not going to screw it up. It's really a simple thing to do. And you can busy yourself with, like I said, wrapping
doing
packages, doing whatever else you need to do.
I don't have a rice cooker, so that's a really good point to grab.
You can, of course, do it on the stove, but I want to eliminate the excuse and the resistance
definitely.
To doing something. Brown rice is a whole food.
Right.
It's not been, the fiber hasn't been taken away, so it's good for the digestive tract. And then we use this as a platform. Now, this could be quinoa. We've talked about quinoa before.
Right.
It could be millet, any kind of grain that's a whole grain.
Right.
But we're using, in this case, brown rice. And then we're going to simply add things in. Here's a chickpea. We want protein. This is, again, I said a canned chickpea.
Right.
Bean that's just been, it's BPA free. We've got
that.
Carrots. So again, we said good for the eyes, but look at the color. Beautiful.
And you just grated those just
I
on your
did.
Own. Did you just buy
but
them and grate?
Honestly, slice it. Who cares, right?
I love it.
It doesn't matter.
The colors are blending so well together. We're going to keep making this too later on in the show. This is just amazing, Katie. I love this. So I can't wait to be continuing this rice bowl. And this morning with holistic health coach Katie McDonald from Be Nourished. And we are putting together the final steps of our rice bowl that we've been making throughout the hour. So what is the next step?
So honestly, the next step is just throwing in whatever you want.
Oh, this is my kind of recipe, honestly. It's easy, it's delicious, it's healthy, it's everything.
Well, you talked about colorful, and if we want a colorful, vibrant life,
right,
we're not gonna find it in food dye.
Very true.
Eat as close to the natural source. Envision it in nature, and that's what you want to eat. Get as close to its original source.
Is that how you decide, too, what you're going to be putting into some of your dishes? Through color?
I do it through color, and I do it through what is it going to do for me? What am I serving, and how is it going to serve me?
Right.
It's got to be that filter.
I'm telling you, you're changing my whole way of thinking.
I have that effect.
No,
I have to warn you.
The red onion, I'm going to be putting that in everything now.
Onions every day.
I love that.
No question. Garlic as well. So I want to just walk through. We did the chickpeas, great source of protein, wonderful source of really good carbohydrate.
Right.
We have the carrots, great for our eyes. We want to get some cruciferous vegetables in here.
Okay.
You can use a red cabbage, again, beautiful color. You can use broccoli. Mm-hmm. The steam of the brown rice actually kind of steams and softens the vegetables.
I was just going to ask you that, if anything has to be cooked.
You can steam it, but heck, why?
Absolutely.
The goal is to get as fed as possible so that you can go out and do everything that you want to do for the season, that you can live the season intentionally instead of surviving it.
I love it.
So let's add, we also have sprouts here. So I put some broccoli in here because the rice was still warm.
It added some beautiful color to it.
Feel free to steam it if you want in advance. Again, the closer to nature as possible, the less, the nutrients stay intact.
Closer to nature as possible.
It's a great way to choose everything. I've got cucumbers in here as well.
Okay.
Cucumbers are cooling.
Right.
So the cooling, a lot of our struggles in health are inflammatory issues. So you want to cool it. You want to put the flame
cucumber
out.
I love it.
Cucumber. Also great for the skin and, of course, hydrating and zero calories.
That's true, absolutely. Yeah.
Not that I care. I don't care as much about the calorie, but I care about the quality.
Absolutely, to know that, definitely.
Parsley. Great, it's a leafy
and
green.
But
let's get some more in there.
Okay.
And then I have
love
sprouts.
Parsley.
I grew these in the kitchen.
Did you?
Yeah. Oh, it's so easy.
Oh, my goodness.
So Williams Sonoma just makes this four-tier thing. You just put the seeds, you water it, and poof.
And done.
Yeah.
And just
pop them constantly.
Right in?
Absolutely.
So there's no right or wrong to this. It's kind of like however
clean
much you want.
Clean out your fridge. That's the way I see it. Make sure there are beans
in there.
There's
a lot of stuff in there just to get out.
Absolutely. It's a perfect way. We're going to add a little bit of olive oil, if you would grab that from there.
Sure.
And then I made this sauce. So I just want a little bit.
Do you see how nervous I usually am in the kitchen?
Yeah, get over it.
I know. I blame my husband.
No, honestly.
He's so good in the kitchen, and I don't feel like I am.
But you know what? No, honestly, let that go and just look and say, what do I want? What do I need? What does my body need?
That's true.
Right? Nobody's judging this. We're feeding our bodies.
Right. And what was this in front?
Oh, hemp seeds. Let's get some of those in there, too. Hemp seeds, great source of protein.
I love
any
it.
Kind of seed. There's more calcium in a sesame seed, for instance, than you'd find in a lot of dairy products.
No way!
So this is a tahini sauce. And are you familiar with tahini?
Yes.
Okay,
yep.
It's just ground sesame seeds.
Right?
Yep.
And you made this.
I did, but really, it's ground sesame seeds. So tahini, lemon juice, and fresh garlic.
Smells really good.
Yeah. That's
and
it.
Just put it right on top?
So you can drizzle it on like this.
Okay.
And just mix it up. Or you can just, so we want to mix it up a little bit.
Okay. It smells so good.
Well,
I know this is not smell-o-vision.
I know. I wish it were.
But if it was, it smells so delicious.
So here's the thing. You make a big bowl of grain or a big pot of grain on Sunday. You make a sauce this simple. I mean, really, whirl it twice.
Right.
Done. And then you have it for the week. You can put this on sandwiches. You can thin it out and put it on a salad. It's got to apply. You can put it in a wrap. I mean, it's got to be easy.
I'm making this all weekend. Can I take a bite of this?
Absolutely.
Okay, ready? Is it bad that I'm going to go right from the bowl
and
put the rest in the other bowl?
Okay. You can also
I'm trying to get a clean bite. So.
Go for it. You can also do it with chopsticks. And the reason I brought the chopsticks, you like it? The reason I brought the chopsticks is I want you to slow down. I want you to savor the season so that come, December 26th or after the whole season, we can look back and say, I was present. I was present.
Absolutely.
That was my present.
Oh, my goodness. This is so absolutely delicious. So, so, so delicious. I'm going to head it back out to the Newport. Oh, my goodness. Well, Michaela, we're going to save some for you. So delicious.